growing up was, it was good. I had a good life. We lived in Colorado when I was really young, and then my mom and dad had divorced, and we moved back to St. Paul. My mom and I had always been close. She's a very loving person, and we always had a close connection. We were friends. I remember the first time I experimented with marijuana was in fifth grade. It was a one-time thing, but by high school, it was probably every day, drinking on the weekends, starting to experiment with LSD, cocaine. I tried to hide that from my mom, but I always kind of thought she knew. It was several occasions where we'd have talks about my drug use and about drinking, so these continuous talks about me drinking and me not liking to talk about this anymore, it had finally got to the point that it was time to leave the house. I thought if I leave from home and in the area and the people that I'm hanging around with, life's gonna improve and get better. Yet, I didn't know the saying of no matter where you go, there you are. Over the next 20 years is how I found out this disease progresses. I started to do a lot of jail time, have a lot of encounters with the police, and I can no longer hold a job. And I can't be accountable or responsible to anything. I'm always still trying to stay in contact with my mom because she'll bail me out. And it gets to the point of the probation is now gonna send me to prison. And while I'm in Washington County Jail waiting to go, now I'm really sorry, and I write this letter to my mom. And 2 days later, I had received an envelope back, and it was my letter, unopened, with a post-it note on there, and it said, "I love you, I'm praying for you, but I can no longer watch you kill yourself." And my initial thought on that was, how dare you? How dare you stop giving me money and stop being there for me? See, I had taken it that she's no longer there for me. I can't stay in contact with my mom, and I wasn't gonna quit using drugs. I find myself in a hotel with nowhere to go, and I had barely eaten or slept in days. Out of my mouth, in a literal sense, I said, "God, I need your help." And I remember immediately thinking, who just said that? And I was answered. I'm getting tingles right now thinking about it. The room gets very quiet, and it's in a sense that everything around me shut down, and I can hear on my right side a voice saying, "Just stop." And it was, "Just stop with the lies. Just stop with the running. Just stop everything." And I don't know how to react to this, but along with that came a feeling of calm and peace and serenity that no high had ever given me, that no sleep had ever given me. I didn't know what the outcome or what tomorrow was gonna bring, but I knew I was gonna be okay. I was touched by God that night. 3 days later, I was introduced to the director of this Christ Recovery Program at CRC at the Union Gospel Mission at a place I never thought I would end up. And that was December 8th was the day that I moved in, 2010. And from there, my life has changed immensely. One of the things I'll always remember is, like I said, I hadn't talked to my mom in so long. I had this feeling that I needed to contact her, called her home, and I said, "Mom, I'm turning myself into recovery, and I think I'm gonna like it here." Since coming into the Christ Recovery Program, in the last 3 years has been a miraculous turnaround. And it started with just someone being glad you're there, somewhere to sleep, somewhere to get a meal, and to know that you can just breathe and relax. And so I've developed a relationship with Christ, which is an amazing feeling to know that no matter what I do or where I go, He's with me and guides me. And He's allowed me to see the things that I needed to change and told me I was forgiven for a lot of things and that I also need to forgive others and that I need to be involved in my family's life again. My mom and I's relationship is amazing again. We're back to we can talk. We do all sorts of things together now. I'm back working. And I think the biggest thing is just knowing who I am through Christ and being comfortable with who I am today. So, to wrap it up in a nutshell, is life perfect today? Pretty much.